something. Everybody love, everybody know. I've been knocking dough down like a witness. God is my witness, I'm witness. But on the real, I think I need another witness. If it was 1717, black daddy, white mama wouldn't change a thing. Light skin, certified as a house. Go figure, in my blood is the blood, venom master. It's like the devil playing space with the pastor. But he was born with the privilege. Man, what the fuck is that? People told me as a child, as a little boy playing with his toys, I should be ashamed. Some people look ashamed when I rap, like my great granddaddy didn't take a pickle to the back. Not accepted by the better ghetto. I don't give a fuck, praise God, I can see the light. Everybody talk about race this, race that. I wish I could erase that, face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some. Everybody love, everybody know how it goes.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's Rodgers' Dolphins going up against Ryan's Bills.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Miami Dolphins and the Buffalo Bills. Gets fielded in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. First carry for LeSean McCoy. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Again, it's McCoy. And some space here. He finds an opening past the 40. He's at the 40. Past the 20. 10. And all the way home for the Bills touchdown. LeSean McCoy, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bills have taken the early lead. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. Fielded about a yard deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Johnson, and he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. It's Johnson, and this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Rodgers Rodgers to throw on second down. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Give him 30 yards there.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. We're only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And what's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep.
They stay on the ground on first with Johnson. And this time they're able to bottle him up as he'll stop him at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. On second down, here's Rodgers. Over the middle, complete. That's James. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Just a yard, but that's all they needed. And by the slimmest of margins, it'll be first and goal. Diggs in motion left. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
This will be play number 8 on the drive. It's third and goal. Size. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. He loses 4, and it brings up 4.
Brandon, I believe that they were in 4-down territory, and that's what they were thinking. But after the loss, I've got to kick the field goal. No way I'm going to go for it in this situation. But you know, some of these coaches, they're extremely unpredictable, and they may go ahead and press it.
A first update now from Cincinnati, and the Bengals out to the early advantage. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. Now it's Sturgis converted on the field goal. Now he'll send this one away on the kickoff. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Bills' offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac. Did you trade 6s for 3s? Things are going to work out in your favor.
They'll start the drive with a carry by McCoy. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. On second down, it's McCoy. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It'll be a loss of a yard, and just like that, it's third down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
And not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. And he locates Josh Hill, complete. Give him 18 on that one as the Bills are going to have a first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Second down following the run. And the former Heisman winner, this is Mark Ingram. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Third down, Ryan. And this is going to be incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Allen on to punt as he gets this one away. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bashed it.
Super toe.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football. And they've got it here with a first down. Again, it's Johnson. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. He came out ready to play. That's three tackles for a loss, Charles, really in the second quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing and is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. Might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball.
Rodgers now to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's James. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make it third down. To throw is Rodgers. Over the middle, complete. That's James. Now a loose football. The ball comes out. Now this is picked up by the Bills.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet there are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. They'll run with Ingram here to begin the drive. There goes Mark Ingram. 30, 10, 5, and all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Mark Ingram, his first touchdown of the new season. And his guys get the quick strike touchdown. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And out come the Dolphins now. And a fumble last time. False security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the... And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. Now this is picked up by the Bills. And some room to roam now. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game film, and only if they manage to win the game.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
If they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive.
He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Now it's Rodgers. And he fires one, but incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
It would be a very makeable field goal try from here, but instead they're going to go for it. They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. And that is going to be incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Bills are going to get the football back. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you and I both been to practices where we've seen, hey, third down situation, big third down alert, lock in here, fourth down play, make sure you're focused just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
They'll keep it on the ground with McCoy this time. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
They'll go again to McCoy. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. They'll try to run for the first with Ingram. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground.
Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage and that's it. No gain on the play there. Second down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Three.
midfield now. Here's Ryan. He's got his man. This is Tate. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Not at all.
Because those are the types of plays that he provides. When he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Buffalo after this. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Now a first down carry here for McCoy. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
And they'll keep it on the ground with McCoy. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down. And now following the incomplete pass, we'll get a timeout here for an injured player. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. To throw on 3rd down, Ryan, he is going to find Hill here. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
From the shotgun, Ryan. This will be caught just inside the 10. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
This offense, 2 for 2 on 3rd downs on this drive. This is the most important of them all, 3rd and goal. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And Lambeau will put this one through, and the lead stretches. 16-3 now. So they get the field goal, but part of that was a 14-play drive to get the 3.
Normally, when you hold the ball that long, run that many plays, you end up in the end zone. There's a breakdown on the defense. Something happens. In this case, that didn't. But really good ball control by the offense. They're hoping that they can wear them down if they keep having drives like that.
This will be taken in at the 1. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Elsewhere, 2nd quarter in D.C. And the Redskins there out to an early lead. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. Fake here on 1st down. Now look out, Rodgers lost the football.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Throwing on 2nd down. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And he's got some space here. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is fielded at the goal line. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
Now Rodgers to try again after the pick six. He's going to take another shot here. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. That'll bring up second down. Now a 10th carry for Johnson. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. So we've reached halftime here in Orchard Park with the Bills taking the lead into the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This fielded at the two. And he'll get it up just past the 20 and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They go to Johnson again. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
26.
On second down, Johnson. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position. The guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front is...
And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off by Levante David. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. Fresh set of downs here. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. Oh, twisting away. And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the center.
Williams loses the football, and the Bills have recovered. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the...
Man, I'm not...
They'll start on the ground with McCoy. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down.
Another good run there, and now we're seeing an offense that's imposed its will on a defense. When we talk about that all the time, what does it really mean? It means that the guys on the offensive line, they feel like they can do whatever they want. They're in the huddle saying, run it again. Give us another chance to smack someone and create some space. On the defensive side of the ball, not only have they imposed their will against you, you're almost powerless to figure out what you're doing there, but you got to keep your spirit up at the same time, and they're taking that too.
A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Again to McCoy. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Give him two on that run, and they're still left looking at a third and about nine to go.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
Hey, let's go.
On third down, Ryan. And he'll win it over the middle. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. 16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down. This is Ingram on first and 10. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
They'll run it now out of the gun. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. They'll try and run for it with McCoy. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. It'll be called a gain of 2, and that'll leave them with some options here on 4th and inches. Now on 4th and inches, they're going to want to talk this over. We get a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches.
Hey, let's go.
They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Bills' drive stalls out on 4th down. And the Dolphins' defense is able to hold. The Dolphins' offense now working their way back onto the field. And last time, the turnover on the fumble. And they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard. Had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance. And to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Going deep here for Bryant. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on, and it's second down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Johnson running right. And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads. Took him right off his feet. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on 3rd and a tough 9. Here's Rodgers. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on 4th. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Fuller brings it in over the middle. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well, well short of a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and that's going to make it second and 14. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And an alley to run. A nice job of eluding the pressure there, scrambling for 11.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
On third down, here's McCoy. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. They'll go with McCoy, going absolutely nowhere. He'll wind up losing a yard or two. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Dolphins get the football in great field position. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. They give to Johnson going right. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Here's Rodgers, looking to throw on second down. Going deep here for Bryant. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary can really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to him.
And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the Bills are going to get the football back. Back onto the field now comes the Bills' offense. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Second down, Ryan. He completes it to Tate. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
I think that was a pretty good read right there. They caught him in zone defense and went to the hitch. And because they're in zone, that creates a natural space between the defenders and the receiver, able to get it to him quickly and let him get upfield.
3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open.
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. And this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. from the red zone now. Here's Ryan on first down. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Josh Gordon, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Bills will extend their lead. This offense certainly looking a lot more comfortable here at home. They lost last week in the opener on the road, but there's something about that home opener makes you feel more settled.
Yeah, I wish we could quantify it, too, because you're playing the same game. The field's the same, you know, size. We know all of that. But being at home, sometimes when you do things well, you get that extra push from your home fans, and it elevates your game.
And in the driver's seat right now, here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. And that one carries out of the side of the end zone for a touchback, so that will come out now to the 25-yard line. So now here come the Dolphins. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Now Rodgers to throw on second down. And this one's incomplete. The intended receiver was David Johnson. And it's third and short. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's...
Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to it.